In this video, I'm going to look at the impact on efficiency and therefore range when you're towing with an electric vehicle. So the vehicle is a 2024 Tesla Model Y. This is a single motor rear wheel drive. And in the UK, all our right-hand drive Teslas come from Shanghai, and this has got the CATL LFP battery. And the trailer is a twin-axle Ifor Williams GD85, so that's an 8x5-foot trailer, and the unladen weight on this is 525 kilograms. So on this video, I'm going to drive a route in the car to measure the efficiency without the trailer attached. Then I'm going to come back and attach the trailer and do the same route with the trailer empty. And then I'm going to load the trailer to the maximum payload of the vehicle and then do the same circuit and look at what efficiency loss we have with an empty trailer versus a loaded trailer. My suspicion is that driving with an empty trailer is going to have a larger impact than driving with 1 ton of weight in the back. I've done videos in the past putting weight in electric vans, and it doesn't have that huge impact on the range that people predict. And I think the same thing's going to happen here. I think driving with just the trailer attached is going to have such an impact on the aerodynamics that that's going to have more of an effect on the efficiency of the vehicle rather than actually putting the weight in the back. But anyway, let's see what happens. So the first thing I've got to do is go for a drive without a trailer attached, and I'm going to do exactly the same circuit on all three trips, and I'm going to try to drive exactly the same as well. So I've got it in chill mode just because that's more appropriate when you've got the trailer attached, and I'm going to drive to a maximum of 60 miles an hour because that's the maximum speed you can drive with a trailer, so I've got to remember to do that on this trip. I have reset my trip. I've done 2 miles already, and I've also got the heating turned off, but I do have my heated seat on. So I've turned the heating off just so I can get this as accurate as possible, because if I had the heating on, the heater use might vary between each journey, because the temperature is going to rise this morning. So the outside temperature may be a little bit different between each journey, maybe by 1 or 2 degrees. And a heater can have quite an impact on the economy when you're doing shorter trips. So I didn't want the heater use to skew the economy, because I'm not going to be driving too long. I'm going to drive for about half an hour, maybe 40 minutes on each one. So I'm back. Let's have a look at the trip. So I've done a 46 minute drive. I've done 34 miles, used 7 kilowatt hours of energy, and my average efficiency has been 217 watt hours per mile. So I've now attached the trailer. Let's just pull that jockey wheel up really tight, and let's go and drive the same circuit. So we've now got trailer mode enabled up there because it has detected that something's plugged into the electrical socket. So let's now go to trips, and we will reset trip A again. So when I showed you the trailer mode symbol, it was lit red, and that's usually when there is a problem, and that's when something isn't connected properly to the electrical socket, and it goes blue when everything is okay. So one thing I quite like about the Tesla is you can turn on the rear camera feed and leave this running, and that's quite reassuring to see the trailer behind you, because I can't see it in the rear view mirror. All I can see is the top of the ramp. And I also can't see it in my side mirrors, because that trailer is exactly the same width as the car is. I can just see the spare wheel on that side, and that's all. So yeah, these camera feeds are very handy on a Tesla, and the image is very sharp and high resolution as well, which is nice. So the wind has really picked up today. It's quite a blustery day, so obviously that's going to have a bit of an impact on the driving efficiency, and maybe more so when I've got the trailer attached. But anyway, I'm driving down the A34 here, dual carriageway, and trying to keep to the maximum speed limit of 60 there, because that's the most you can do while you're towing a trailer. But I did the same when I did my initial route as well. So I've just got back from the second circuit, and again it's been 34 miles. It's been, well actually it was 48 minutes, so it's taken 2 minutes longer the second time round, and the energy consumption has jumped up hugely to 459 watt hours per mile. And the battery is at 59% already, yet we've only driven 69 miles today. So the trailer has obviously had a huge impact in the efficiency already. But anyway, let's load the trailer up, and I'm going to load it up to pretty near the maximum 1600 kilogram weight that this vehicle can take, and I'll do the drive again. So, a bag of stone here. Put that over the axles, and I would say this is probably at least 600 kilos. Right, that's in the middle of the trailer. I'll go and find some more stuff to load up. So what I've got in here is obviously the bag of stone, and then I found a load of car batteries. They are very heavy, and I've put ratchet straps across just to give that a bit of protection in case I'm involved in an accident and they were to bounce out. That might make them sort of bounce back in. And the stone is strapped down as well. So I don't think this is up to the maximum of 1600 kilograms total. Obviously the trailer is very heavy in this case, but it's not too far off. But I'm struggling to find anything else of any particular weight to put in the back. So that will do for now. Let's get on and do the road trip again. So let's reset trip A again and then do the same journey. So the battery is at 58%, and let's see what the efficiency is like on this drive. Already I can feel that weight behind. I've never had quite so much weight in the trailer before, and normally you can't feel the trailer behind the car. You can feel it knocking where it gets bounced around with the bumps, because this trailer, being a twin axle and it's designed to take a lot of weight, I think you can put about 2.2 tons in this trailer. Obviously you can't when you've got it behind the Tesla, but the leaf springs are very stiff on it, and with the sort of weight I normally carry in it, it's not flexing the suspension. It tends to bounce quite a bit over the bumps, so you feel that, but you can't feel the weight of the trailer, as it were. But that's different now. I can definitely feel a pulling at the back. But of course, that extra weight should help when you're slowing down, because that should increase the regen, because you'll have more mass pushing on the electric motor. But this trailer is braked, and the brakes are adjusted only a couple of days ago, and they're absolutely spot on. And I've just serviced it, and it's got new brakes as well. So the brakes are working very well. But I'm assuming it will help with the regen when I am slowing down with the extra mass behind us. I can test that now, actually, because we're on a bit of a downhill. I'm going to slow down to turn right at this roundabout. Am I getting any more regen at the top there? No, I don't think so. I did have to touch the brakes there, though. Oh, look at this, an old series Land Rover with the top off. Lovely. I used to have one. Actually, yeah, mine was the same as that. I've had various series Land Rovers over the years. Anyway, let's do this 45 minute drive again, and unless anything happens, I'll catch up with you when I get back. So I've just got back, and let's have a look at the trips. So it was 47 minutes, 34 miles again, this time used 15 kilowatt hours of energy and averaged 443 watt hours per mile. Now the battery is at 31% with a predicted range of 81 miles, but that's based on the new inefficient driving with the trailer attached, of course. So anyway, I'm going to go and grab a cup of tea, and then I'll come back and have a look at the results. So I've got my cup of tea, so let's have a look at these results. So the first trip out, just to get the base economy of this car in today's conditions, it was a 34 mile trip. Each trip took 47 minutes on average. That used 7 kilowatt hours of energy, and that averaged 217 watt hours per mile. I've been driving a Tesla now for over 2 years. I still can't get to grips with watt hours per mile. Anyway, I've converted all of these into miles per kilowatt hour, and that was 4.61 miles per kilowatt hour. So on the second trip out towing the trailer, I used 16 kilowatt hours of energy. So that's more than twice the amount of energy on the same journey. That was an average of 459 watt hours per mile, which equates to 2.81 miles per kilowatt hour. And then the third trip out, I used 15 kilowatt hours of energy. So just as I predicted, the weight doesn't make any difference at all, because I was driving more economically with a heavy trailer than a light trailer. So it's more about the aerodynamics, and the upset in aerodynamics there is affecting the efficiency of the vehicle a lot more than the weight you've got in the trailer. And actually in that trailer I've got a 700 800, yeah, I've got a good 800 kilograms in that trailer. And of course the trailer is heavy in the first place. That trailer is 525 kilos, which is a much heavier trailer than people would typically tow behind a vehicle. But anyway, on that third trip, I averaged 443 watt hours per mile, which is 2.26 miles per kilowatt hour. So very interesting results, and the batteries didn't move much either. And it's as I predicted, having a trailer behind is going to affect your economy more than the weight you have in it. And clearly in this case it was more economical on the second journey out with the trailer with it loaded than it was empty. So it's clearly down to aerodynamics. So most people wouldn't have a trailer this big behind a car and this heavy. So obviously weight does play a little bit part of it, because this is a heavy trailer in the first place. But I do wonder, with this particular trailer, this is obviously causing a bit of an air brake. This is a mesh at the top, so air's going to flow through that, but not that bottom bit. So I do wonder with this trailer whether it's worth getting a cover. You can get covers for these for about £100. And I suspect that would have quite a big impact on the efficiency. Obviously, you can't use a cover when you've got stuff in there, unless it's very low, like those batteries. But I might invest in a cover and then have another go at this test. Anyway, that will do for this video. If you found it useful, please do click the thumbs up button. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. And if you want to know more about the Tesla Model Y, I'll put a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can see those other videos. I'd actually like to do the test with a smaller, unbraked single axle trailer. So if anyone locally is watching this and is in South Oxfordshire and has got a trailer like that and they're willing to lend it to me for a day, then I think that will make quite an interesting video as well.